In this video, I'm going to show the new JSON functions in FileMaker 16. So right here I have a copy of our free template FN Quick Start running in 16. I'm on this contact record here, and I've made a field that creates a JSON document with a few attributes from the contact. So the first name, the last name of the contact, and then, and I'll explain this in more detail, it's taking all of the related addresses of the contact and making an array in the JSON from it, this custom function right here. But first, let me show you what this JSON field looks like. All right. So right here is the JSON field. So we've got the address array, and we have two addresses for this contact. And then we have the first name and the last name. Okay, so that's what that JSON looks like. So the first thing I want to show is how to update an existing JSON document like the one I just showed you. The function to do that is the JSON Set Element function. So let me go back into this field, and I'm going to add the company of this contact as another attribute of the JSON. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take this JSON Set Element, which I already have, and you can see there's these brackets here. This is called the bracket notation. It's very similar to the substitute function. You can have as many of these. Each bracket is an element that you're adding to the JSON document, which in our case, we're starting with a blank JSON object here. So I'm going to add a new element to add here. We're going to do company, and then the argument. So that first argument's the key, and the second argument right here in the brackets is the actual value, which I'm going to go ahead and use the company field. And then the third argument is the type, the data type of this value, which in this case is a string. The company is a string. It's a piece of text. Okay, so there we go. Press OK. And let's take a look at the new JSON here, and you'll see that it added the company of this contact, which is Crimson Lance. Good deal. I want to go ahead and show you one more attribute to add. I want to add the contacts, whether they're active or not. So the isActive boolean, so isActive, and then isActive here. And in this case, this is not a string, this is a number. So I'm going to change it to JSON number. There are six different data types that you could put here. There's a string, number, there's a boolean, which we can actually do boolean here if we want, but we're going to go ahead and keep it number. And then there's also JSON array, JSON object, and something called JSON raw. I'm going to save that. If we go take a look at our JSON, you'll see that isActive has been added, and in this case, this contact is active, so it has the value 1. Good deal. Okay, so that is how you add multiple elements to an existing JSON. And I'm going to go with one more here because I want to show you a path. Because right now I've just been showing you basic keys. So in this case, this is just a key, this is just a key. I want to show you how to add, and I want to do it this way. I want to show you how to add using this JSON here. Let's say I want to add a country to this first address here in the existing JSON document. So to do that, let me do JSON set element, and then we're going to use this existing JSON document, and then the path to that first address is address, and then because the address is an array, you have to tell FileMaker, which index in the array that you're looking to update. In this case, I want the 0 index because arrays in JSON start with 0 instead of 1. And I want to update this first address. And then I'm going to do a dot country, which is our new attribute. And let's just say US. And then the data type is JSON string. Okay, well, we got JSON back, but it's very hard to read. So let's do JSON format elements to make this easier to read on us. And so now if you take a look, country has been added to just the first address. You'll see the second one doesn't have it, only the first one, and it does have US there. And that's because I told FileMaker just to add country for the first address. So this is a path right here. Paths are where most of the power comes in to these JSON functions. And paths start from the top of the document, and you start from the left at the top, and then you work your way into the element you're looking to add or modify. And you separate elements by dots. Okay, so that is how you update JSON or modify an existing JSON. So let's take a look at deleting an element from an existing JSON document. So I'm going to take this document we're currently working with, the contact JSON, okay, and I'm going to use the JSONDeleteElement function, and I want to delete the last name element. So I'm just going to type the key, the last name key, and it looks like it worked because we got JSON back. And so if you scroll down here, you'll see there is no longer a last name element there. So that is how you use the delete element function. All right, now let's look at how to get the value of an element, which is going to be one of the most common JSON functions that people will use. So let me delete this one. And let's do JSONGetElement. And let's say that I want to get the second address's type. Okay, so let's do the DCT JSON. And then we're going to give it a path here instead of a key, because we have to tell FileMaker exactly which type you want, because there's multiple types because we have an array of addresses. And so the path is address, and then I want the second address, so that's index one, dot type. There we go. We got the second address's type, which is billing, so that's exactly what we wanted. Okay, and there's a couple more JSON functions to look at here. We also have the JSON list keys and JSON list values function. So let me show you the list keys. So let's say that I wanted to do a list, JSON list keys of just the elements at the top of the JSON object. So these are the top level elements of the JSON document we're working with. So that's what we expect. Now, JSON list keys, the most common use case for this will be to count the number of elements in an array. And so to do that, let me just show you what happens if I do a list keys on an array. So because our address is an array, and you'll see it lists the indexes. So all you need to do to then count the number of objects in an array is to do a value count on that list of indexes. And so there we go. This is how to count how many objects are in an array. Okay, and so finally, I want to show you how to get a list of values. So there is a JSON list values function. And I want to get all of the values of the first address. So to do that, I'm going to give it the JSON document. That's the first argument. And then a path again. In this case, I want address 0. And there we go. It lists out all of the values of all the different elements in the first address in the JSON document. All right, so that's all of the new JSON functions. You can build, you can create, modify, and parse pretty much any JSON function that you, or excuse me, any JSON document that you want with those list of functions. The final thing I just want to show you real quick is this custom function that I showed at the beginning. If you take a look at this address array, I wanted a way to use FileMaker's list function to get a list of addresses and then convert them into an array easily. So I made a custom function for this. And so I wanted to show you how that works. So the first thing is to go to the addresses table, because one contact can have many addresses, right? And I made a JSON field here, and all this does is it creates a JSON object that represents this address. And so when I do a list on, that related JSON field using a relationship to the addresses table, you'll see I get back those addresses as the JSON objects, and they are return delimited. But JSON itself does not use returns as delimiters in an array. What it uses is commas. And so I need a way to convert this into a comma-separated list, which you can do with substitute. But if I go back into, this calculation, if I just did a substitute on that list, it still wouldn't work because FileMaker is expecting an array object, which I'm trying to give it a comma-separated list of objects instead of an actual array. So all you need to do with that comma-separated list of objects is to concatenate the opening square bracket and the closing square bracket, and then you'll have an array, and that will work. So that's what this custom function does, is it takes, so we go down to, well, it's creation order here, but go down to the JSON object list to array. All it's doing is taking your return delimited list, and then it's doing a substitute, and it's changing the return to a comma. It's doing it safely by using the curly brackets, the delimiters, those object delimiters. That way we don't change real returns in the JSON data. And it's returning those, it's substituting that and making a comma. And then we're just concatenating those two angle brackets. So just to show you this, so what we saw here, this list of objects, if I do the JSON object list to array, there we go. Let me JSON format elements just to make that slightly more readable. There we go. And so I now have an array that I can then insert into another JSON document as an array, which is what we did there in that contact JSON. So that's it.